Okay.
We can start. Good evening, everyone. We are flying far, far away tonight with our flight levels, and our pilot is Oliver. Oliver, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Can you please introduce yourself?
Sure. So you already heard it. My name's Oliver. I'm working as an enterprise agile coach. I'm guiding companies and people on their way, on their agile journeys, on their growth path and stuff like that. And a few years ago, I got to know Klaus Leopold, who introduced his book, Flight Levels. You know the Flight Levels book, the blue one, maybe some of you have seen it already. And I was actually quite impressed by the idea of letting people think on their own what they think might be the right processes and behavior towards value creation. And I really liked the idea, and so I decided to do the education with Klaus and also another coach called Siegfried Kaltenegger. They are both the coaches there. The education is called Flight Levels Coach, can be booked, and I really actually enjoyed it. And it totally fits together with the idea that I think how agility or change should work. It's by integrate people in things and give them the opportunity to participate and think for themselves what's right for them, because actually I think they are the experts of their work. And so I decided to go down this road and offer these workshops and change initiatives combined with something that we call solution focus, which is a communication technique. And I really enjoyed at the moment working with my actual client. We are introducing it, and I will show you after the flow experiment also how we did the change, if you're interested in that. I will show you everything, all the boards and stuff, or the workshop at least, and so you can ask me questions after that if you want to. But for now, I would really love to start, and don't talk about myself, to invite you to something that's called True and Positive. It's a check-in method. It was developed by Nancy Klein. And I will open some breakout sessions for you. If you're not in the mood to talk to others, just leave it. You have the possibility to come back to the main room. The idea is that you tell each other what you think went well during the last weeks, and what you're really proud of. And I want you to answer it quickly, because we have about around 4 minutes time for that. So one person asks the next person, what did really went well during the last 2 weeks in your work, and what are you proud of? Then you answer it and you ask the next question. And when you're finished, you can do whatever you like if there's time left, or just come back to the main room. Any questions so far?
No.
Okay. So let's start. See you in 4 minutes.
See ya.
Seven, six, five.
Final countdown.
Yay, there we go. Look at those smiling faces. I knew it.
That is good, right?
So probably a lot of things went well. I'm happy to see that.
Well, we were talking about what we are proud about, right?
Okay, so before I will share my workspace link with you for the mural that we will work on today, I will just guide you very quickly what we're going to do now, and I will share my screen with you. There we go. So hopefully you can see this one. What we're going to do now, before I explain everything to you, we're just going to do it and you find out for yourself. I think that's the better way around. So this is an interactive thing today. This is a board, and people will work on this board today. And you can see several columns there that are called potential work, pre-production, surrounding, painting, shaping, sizing, packaging, and scent. And there you can see something special, this clock, because we will have one timekeeper for each one of those boards. So we start with the first three boards, and then in the second round, we will work in a different system. I will tell you later. In the first round, we will work in a push system where work is pushed from one column to the next. And as you can imagine, those columns are not about people. Those columns are actually teams or areas in your company or different departments, whatever you can imagine. But in our case, only one person is actually working on one column. So what we will do is that you are going to write your name here in these post-its, whether you like to work on one of these columns and stations. And as we have only 21 for this workshop, 21 free seats, I would ask those people who are sure that they can stay until the end of the workshop, or at least until the end of those two rounds. Second thing, it would be of a great advantage if you have a PC or a laptop and a mouse. I know it's not working with handies, and I think you will also have troubles with tablets to do the work there. And I will show you now why. So the first person that will work here, I call him Sam for now. And I will call the second person Susie. Sam will be our sales department. And there are a lot of ideas here, potential work. And what Sam will do in the first round is he will pull a post-it inside and he will give it the number. Number one, when it's done, he pushes the work into column two. Then he takes the next one and numbers it number two and so on. And he always pushes things. And the person in the second column, in this case, Susie, she then adds a frame and it's working like this. You click on the post-it and there is this little frame sign. It's the border. Okay. And when you've done that, you leave it and you push it to the next column. And please always click into the white, area so that you release the post-it. Otherwise it's locked. And you do the same thing with this and so on. And whatever comes from Sam, you will just do your work. And the person in the third column will change the color of the post-it from green to light blue and push it to the next column. And always keep in mind the numbers. You need to work them through by 1, 2, 3 and so on. The person in the next column in shaping will change the orientation of the post-it. And it works like this. You click on the post-it, then you go to this corner here, and that's why it's tricky and not working with smartphones or tablets that well. And then you can change the orientation. I do it again. On the corner, there comes this light blue arrow, and then you can rotate it. Okay? And rotate it, that's just a little out of line. And then you push it to sizing. The person in the column sizing will take the post-it, move it inside this little box, and tries to make it to fit in here. You don't have to do it exactly, but almost exactly. Don't let perfect be the enemy of good. And then you push it into packaging. And packaging will do several steps. Step one is you open the menu on the left side here. You take this square, change the color to gray. Oh, the color here. Gray or light gray, I don't mind. You can choose. And then move it over the blue one. Then with shift mouse or something, or you can click them both with shift, it works, or move it over, you mark both. Then you right click it and you say group. Okay? Then it's grouped and then you can move it both together and you push it into the sandbox. Okay. We will, by the way, practice this before we start the real deal. Our timekeeper has the following task. Anytime such an item enters the sandbox, you will take one of those little lines and move it into the minute that it arrives. So in minute number one, it might be arriving, from experience, I would say one or two. And you will have a stopwatch on your handy. Okay, use your stopwatch and start it when I say start. We will practice this too. So when I say start, you will start your stopwatch counting up. And after, I guess it was, no, after 2 minutes, we will stop the whole session. When I say stop, you pause the time. Don't refresh it, just stop it. And then everyone needs to stop working. And then we will count our work in process. We will count how many work items are in the system after 2 minutes. We will note it down. After 2 minutes, and after we've noted down the work in process, I will put in another post-it and I will color it red. And it is treated the same way as all the green post-its as well. So you just pull it in the first column, sales. And this is a really important one, as you can see, otherwise it wouldn't be red. It's probably a high prior work, maybe introduced by our CEO or I don't know. And then you will also give it the number and push it through the system. Okay. And then I will give you further instructions from there dynamically. You will see. Okay. Any questions so far?
There's no question in the chat, so.
Perfect. The second round, we will change into a pull system with work in progress or process limits. We will have a work of progress limit of one per column. That means only one work in your whole area. Nevertheless, if don't mind if it's in doing or done state, there is not, it's not allowed to have more than one piece of work in your whole column here. And what you are going to do in the second round is you pull something here, and when you're done numbering it, you put it into your done. And everything else I will explain later when we are done with round number one, so that you're not overwhelmed by all the information already. Okay, so now I will share my link with you. In the Zoom chat. Hopefully. Yes. There you go. And if you have any troubles in any way, technical issues or orientation problems, please shout it out as soon as possible, because the success of this experiment also depends on your ability to have a proper technical environment where you're not getting stuck, because then you will interrupt our workflows. Okay. Oh, I already see people naming. So we have 21 free seats and I want you to put your name into number 1, 2, or 3. You can see the outlines on the right side. Maybe I forgot that one. I will share my screen again. There is this little box here on the right side on Mural. And if you click on that one outline, then the outlines open and there you can navigate through the single. Exactly. And we need, sorry, we need names on number 1, 3, and 5. My mistake. So if you want to actively participate, fill in your name in one of those columns in the purple. And of course, you can change the color.
I mean, more people can be in a column, right?
No, only one person.
Okay.
Thanks for the question. You are just one person there in this experiment, but of course, in real life, this would be a whole team or even more, maybe. We don't know, depending on your context. So we're missing two more people on flow A in number 1. Ah, we already have a timekeeper, Boris. Thank you. That's really great. I am, by the way, don't move around any post-its yet. If you're in number 5, maybe you can join number 3 at the moment, because I don't see too many people putting their names inside. At the moment, we only have flow 1 field. Thank you, Danilo. We need 4 more people in flow B.
We can delete Sam and Susie.
Yes, you can delete Sam and Susie. Sorry, of course.
Okay. Susie, Sam, you're out. Sorry.
Danilo, can you move to flow B? That's number 3 in the outline. Ah, you already did. Your timekeeper.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Then I will remove your name on number in the flow C. So, and if the others just want to watch, that's of course fine too. But to start flow B, we need Luca. Thank you. 1 more person. Come on, impossible.
I think we lost Andreas on surrounding on flow A.
Oh.
I think someone put a post-it over my name.
Oh.
And it's locked, so I cannot move that.
Oh, someone is actually locking it. Yes. It's an elephant.
Sabotage from the start.
But I'm still there. I will write myself.
Whoever is in a post, everyone who's in a post-it, click on the white area. Everyone click in the white area. Yeah, no, still not. No, still not. Okay, but we know.
I think somebody wrote his name over my name.
I'm now above and below.
Christian, I was in the pre-production of the flow B.
Uh-huh. Christian.
Good. Then I'll go somewhere else.
I think.
Is there anywhere a free spot?
No, I don't think so. Seats are taken, but it doesn't actually really matter.
Okay.
You are saving stress. That's fine. You will have the same experience without stress. So good. It will be fine.
By the way,
okay,
Oliver, sorry, yes? One recommendation. I recommend you share the screen and pin yourself so we can have it for the recording.
Ah, okay. I will do that. Are you there? Yeah, got it. So, and please don't create post-its from now on. Someone created a post-it again. Okay. Okay, so the timekeepers, do you have your phone at hand or whatever you use for a stopwatch? Yes? No?
Yes.
Timekeeper? Was?
Yes.
Okay, and Danilo. Okay, so let's do a practicing round. you know how to do it, right, Mario? You pull just a green one, you name it, and push it to surrounding. And the same one for the left side. Vladimir, you can start already. And work quickly, please. And push as fast as you can. And if any one of you has technical issues, shout out loud at the moment you do have it, because then we can actually stop the timer and stop working, so we don't have to start again. Mm-hmm. Josip, are you okay?
Yeah, not really. I think my mural is really slow.
Okay.
That's why I saw Barbara kind of putting two or three at the same time.
You're in flow B, right? On on painting. Does it work now?
It's much slower. I mean, if somebody thinks they can be faster,
maybe Christian can jump in. And Alex, are you having trouble coloring?
I'm painting. For now, that's it. Maybe if somebody else can do it faster.
It's Alex, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Let's see. Yeah, you're already the bottleneck here. So maybe, Christian, do you want to jump in?
Are we allowed to jump in when we see a bottleneck?
No, you're not allowed to help. No. But you're allowed to do the job instead, because technical issues will destroy the experiment, honestly. So is someone able to change seat with Alex in flow A? You can stop working for now.
Okay.
We'll try again with a new person. And there are some empty ones I saw. So who wants to take the seat of Alex? Christian?
I can try, but my browser is also very slow. So.
Okay. I mean, that's really interesting. I will hide non-facilitate the cursors. Maybe it's getting faster.
Sorry, it seems I cannot draw for some reason. I found it, I think. No.
You click on the post-it?
No.
Maybe you are in the drawing mode. Is this right? Have on the top?
It's taking me, instead of showing on the packaging where I am, it sends it to the send column. I found it.
Okay. And you are not allowed to package two things at the same time. And take care of the numbers.
Oh, okay.
Exactly. Yeah. Always do it by number.
Trying to trick the system.
Also, the person Bogdan in the sizing, you push the numbers in the correct order, please. Because I can see 5 there already. Are we missing a person in flow B in the painting column at the moment?
Yeah, I'm here, but you told me to stop, so.
No, that's me.
We stopped completely in B.
Yes.
As well.
Okay, we need a working painter. Oh, yeah. A painter in flow B, number 3.
I think he's just missing the name.
I've deleted myself. So I was here, but I concluded. I mean, exactly. We concluded that I'm
really
slow. So we need
slow. A new painter because this was too slow.
I got fired.
And still, Alex, you're still in row number 3 in the painting in flow 1.
Yes, if somebody wants to jump in, no problem.
So, Christian, do you want to take the job now?
Okay, flow A, painting.
Yes, column painting. Please fill in your name, and then we will try again.
And what about flow B?
We have both 3. We need 2 people, actually.
Okay, so you deleted everything.
Yes, we will start again. I will delete all the items.
Are we starting from number 1 again?
Yeah, actually, yes, but not now. First, we need people. So please fill in your name, Christian, on flow A, painting.
Okay.
Thank you. And we need 1 more person in flow B for painting. One person, come on, we're 26 here.
I just realized if I zoom too much, then it will be slower. If you zoom out like I don't know, 16% for me, it's working well. So
okay, so it. Is there no more person for flow B? No one, really?
Give me a second. I will turn off my software camera. Maybe then it will work.
Okay, then thank you, yeah. Josip. That's good. And if it's a little bit better, then it's good. And if you use the bottleneck anyway, doesn't matter. We need a bottleneck, by the way. As usual,
it's
we have
now that it's painting.
Okay, so you just fill in your name again in flow B painting, please. And then if you're ready, we can practice again. So you can start practicing already. Okay, let's go sales. Push, yes. Push. So, Josip, you're in painting, right? I will write the name in for you.
Yeah, it's
Barbara,
actually,
are you here, Barbara? Oh,
yeah. It's actually even worse, so...
Honestly.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, maybe somebody too.
Okay, so with, flow B, I have, thank God, another plan for if it's not working. You can stop working, flow B.
We have no painter.
We have a painter. Who?
There's no painter in.
Yeah, exactly. I have an what's Notfallplan in English? A safety plan. Flow B number 3. Please come to outline number 7. Because there we only have 6 columns.
Do we stop working in board A?
Is it working, Christian?
Really, really slow. So I can't paint.
Okay, so you stop painting, please. The whole flow A number 1, please come to board number outline number 9. This time your flow B with 6 people. So forget about flow A and B number 1 and 3. Please come to number 7 and number 9. There we only have 6 columns. I prepared it already.
I'm number, over there.
Number 9 and number...
Yes, number 7 and number 9. Oh, okay. So fill in your names there. Perfect. And flow B is missing one name. Change the size of the work. And the timekeeper is missing Boris, I guess.
Where, Oliver? In which?
On outline number 9.
9.
Yes,
okay.
Flow B, we need a timekeeper. And then we are ready to go, I see, because and of course we need the items. I will copy paste them.
I'm already on it.
There you have potential work. And then I think we are ready to... No? What just happened?
They went behind, yeah.
Yeah, I put it in front.
Also recommendation, hide everything that we are not using currently. I think that also helps.
Yeah, I will do so. Thank you. Good idea. So, outline, flow A, flow B, flow B, flow B, 7 people, 7 people. Okay. So, okay, let's try again. So one more practicing round and hopefully then we're good to go. I can see a locked item there. Can you please leave it? There's a post-it. Someone made a post-it in our sizing box.
No, I was trying just to draw a square.
Okay.
Deleted it.
Yeah, you can practice again. Okay, let's start. Mm-hmm. Barbara, are you having troubles?
Yeah, it's very slow. Okay, now I can see it.
Perfect.
No, I can't see anything in my column, and I can see on your screen that there is something in my column.
That's really
now it starts.
Maybe I will remove. I will remove actually everything which is not used. I will delete everything. Hopefully that helps.
I got kicked out of the session.
That's quite interesting.
I'm back.
It worked perfectly last time.
So I stopped my camera.
Ah, that might help too, stopping the camera.
Maybe, Barbara, maybe exit all of your tabs in your browser.
Like, yeah.
Completely close your browser and have this only one open.
And refresh maybe.
Good.
I think I am having some lagging problems.
Maybe you refresh your browsers. Could help. I deleted everything we don't need. It's totally gone. Maybe it helps your browser if you refresh. I can see Flow B is actually delivering stuff already. So it's for some reason seems to work better. Barbara, still?
So I'm back on the board. Okay. Now it's working.
Yay. Refreshing. So you practice for a few more items so you know exactly what to do. And don't create new post-its, please. Even though it looks funny. So, Alexander, package. Yeah, that looks good now.
Yeah, what the...
Are you having trouble packaging?
Oops.
Alexander, are you having trouble? Hello? Not talking to me. Alexander?
My overproductivity just killed him.
Well, if FlowB, you can stop. I think you're good. But we have real issues here in Flow A. And if you're not talking to us, that's pretty hard and will not work. Does someone like to jump in on the packaging?
Hey guys, I have an issue, but let just give me a few seconds. Maybe I will recover.
Okay.
So this is still a test, right? This is still a test run.
This is still, it's all a test. Yeah, we're
not doing yet fired.
The technical setup. It needs to run smooth. Everybody needs to run smooth and know what he or she is doing. So, still no reaction here. You have to resize the gray one like this. Ah, that's fine. Okay. Just put it there and group it and then move it. That's fine. Ah, now it seems to work. Maybe you practice 2-3 more items so you can do it quickly. Yay.
Maybe instead of dragging them like that, try grouping them first. It will be much easier for you to drag after you group them. Alexander.
I think he did. They're grouped.
Uh-huh. Cool.
And you're not, of course, you're not allowed to pre-produce things.
Okay.
And you don't help other columns. Everyone is working in this area. You're not allowed to work there.
Okay. It says pre-production. Come on.
So, Alexander, are you okay now?
Yeah. What do you think? Am I doing good job?
Yes, you're doing a great job.
Thank you, mister.
And I totally appreciate that you're making money for me.
Great thing. Likewise.
Perfect. Okay. So if everyone knows what to do now, I think we can start our first round. Oh, what did I just do? Yeah. So there we go. Okay. Delete all the items that are not used.
So Oliver?
Yes.
Sorry, one quick question. What if we get a number that's, what if we get numbers that are not in order in our column?
It's okay.
We just, okay, it's okay. Fair enough. We just carry on.
I'm sorry, I have a question for Christian. Are you doing the sizing in Flow B?
No, right at the moment I'm watching, so.
Okay. So just let me, I'm just going to change your name to mine then.
Ah, thank you, Mario.
Thanks.
Thank you. So, timekeepers, are you ready?
Yes.
Take your stopwatch. Sales, are you ready? Looks like. Then I will count down from five and then I will see you working like hell. Every post-it is 100,000 euros round. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Sales. Oh, wow. Yeah. Perfect work. There we go. Packaging. Go. Packaging, would a bonus help? I can pay a bonus.
Count on that.
Oh no, I deleted the wrong one. Faster. So minute number two is starting now. Okay, we're in minute two already. That looks great.
Luca, please spread a bit these squares. Please, man.
Yes, sir. Please just give me a line. I'll make it just the way you like it.
Roger that.
Packaging. Go. 30 seconds left. When I say stop in 30 seconds, everybody stops working and timekeepers. We only have two here. Packaging is pretty slow here. The third one.
Yes.
I think they are lazy in packaging, aren't they? We should blame them or something. 3 seconds left. 2, 1, stop, pause. Nobody works. So let's see what's happening here. I will share my screen and let's see how many work in progress do we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. We have 27 work in progress here. Ding. And here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Oh, the same, 27. Actually, there is one item in the column packaging which is not resized. I will move it back. That's not allowed. So, and what is our throughput? Well, that's obvious. It's 2. 2.0, because we are not counting minute number 1 because the system wasn't filled at that time. And here we have a throughput of 3. So workflow B will get the bonus, workflow A won't, thank you. Maybe I will fire you, let's see about that. Okay, now I will put in another.
Rick, how is the throughput 3 if they have 4 items completed?
The throughput is counted per, oh, there's another one. Did you just move it there?
No, it was like that.
It was,
I'm in another team. I'm
perfect. Thank you. You saw that. They are double.
It's not
very
like...
well. Thank you.
We're still going to get fired though, but still.
Yeah. They did. Even
that's
better.
Perfect.
But
so
thanks, Brad.
Okay. I'm going to insert a high prior ticket now, and I will color them pink. And for you, the person that is, oh, we are not painting anymore. That's perfect. So you don't have to repaint it. That's good. So it will come out as a pink as well. So business as usual, again, 2 minutes when I say go, you start the time clocks again and you start working exactly where you stopped. Okay, everyone ready?
Sorry, so for the red one, it's just like any other.
Any other, it goes through, you will have the number 31 in flow A and number 33, which is quite interesting. Why would, that's fine, in flow B. You do exactly continue as it was, if it just paused. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. I saw you cheating, packaging.
No.
It's fine. sales, you can stop. So Vladimir and Bogdan, you can stop working. Andreas, of course, you can stop. You're not getting any more work. You stop automatically. So, Baba, you can stop working too. Faster, faster.
No pressure, right?
Yeah, Ben.
No pressure, no. Come on, come on. Money, we need money. Our competitors are hell ahead of us. Packaging. Oh, no, not cheating on the right, on the red one. That's not allowed. Shaping. Shame on you.
So we need to go in order. They can't take the red one immediately.
Exactly.
Even
you need
if it's
to go
priority.
In order. You're not prioritizing the red one.
Uh-huh.
I misunderstood. Sorry. I thought when the red one comes, I need to do it first.
No. I put it back. That's fine.
Yeah. Okay.
Just continue with the green ones. Packaging.
Can you jump in on packaging?
No, you can't. None of your business there, not your working area. And by the way, you don't have the skills.
But we all work in Scrum, like, come on.
No, we're all
developers.
No, we don't.
Different areas. This is not the IT or something.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
I'm joking.
Forget this is my silo.
That's
I'm
your
not
silo,
doing your
right?
job. I'm not paying for doing your job. It's your job to do your job.
Whoever is transferring into packaging, don't pile things up. It makes it hard to see the numbers.
Oh, it doesn't matter in the scent.
Yeah, no problem.
We're all good.
We are past 2 minutes.
Yeah. That's okay.
Okay.
You can still count. You continue working, please.
Wait until we finish.
Actually, we won't probably not. We will not wait till we're finished. Around
really?
8, around 6
so awesome.
Minutes, I will stop this and then we count the throughput and that's fine. Because the bottlenecks are too heavy. I think they are just lazy here.
Where is 16?
Does anyone know of you what these people in packaging are actually doing the whole day? I mean, they're not working, right?
I mean, I'm not sure if you're intentionally doing that, but I think that like packaging and resizing takes a bit more effort than the previous.
Oh, there we go. You think we're
steps, right?
Interesting.
You think we're better than them? Yeah, we do more of the work. We should get better bonuses.
Lazy. They're just lazy people.
So how does this work from minute 3 with 2 to 7 in minute 4? I don't believe that.
So are we doing the whole thing or are we stopping?
No, we will stop in around about 30 seconds. But please come on, work.
Yeah.
Danilo, is this really correct? Number 4, 7 items, and number 3, only just 2 items?
Yeah.
Did someone help out there?
I don't know. I just saw items moving to my column and I do my job.
Okay. And it was the correct minute. Okay, I see.
Alexander, are you... I see you have two
items.
Okay,
you can stop in 5 seconds and... Stop working, everyone.
Okay.
You can stop working. So let's have a look at the throughput at this time. We have two.
What was that after you said stop?
Yeah.
I think.
12 divided, 12, 14 divided by 4. Oh, sorry, 4. What is it? 1, 2, 7, 10, 40. It's 14. 14 divided by 4 is...
3.
Oh, my calculator. is 3.5. Could have used my head. Who cares?
Yeah, but there is like 16 in the column. 16 boxes.
Oh, so actually... Danilo, you didn't count right. Is it possible?
No, I think he counted right. There, one is from the first minute, and the one was added after you said stop.
Okay, so
yeah,
we moved out.
So it's actually 14.
It's
14 is the
correct. Perfect. Then we have 3.5 throughput here, and here we have 4, 10, 13, 16, 17 divided by. It was in minute 6 already. We don't count that. Can I move one back? It was out of the time already. So it's 4, 10, 16 divided by 4. Again, I need my calculator. Divided by 4 is...
4?
4! Yeah, thank you.
I thought you were joking.
See, totally confused. So you were almost the same speed, 3.5 and 4. That's fine. So, and let's see how much is in the box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1. It's 18. If we do 18 divided by 3.5, it would have taken another 5 minutes to get there. So the lead time would be 7 minutes here for the red one. And the lead time is when the red item would have finished the process from start to the end. So it took 7 minutes around. And here we have... Four and a half minutes plus 2 is 6:30. The lead time here is 6:30.
Sorry, I didn't understand. Why are you adding 2 on that number?
Yeah, that is confusing to me.
Excuse me.
We started at 2 minutes for that one. Right?
We started at 2 minutes.
Yeah, we started at minute number 2, the red item. So we need to what's minus?
Minus.
Thank you.
It's also minus for most of the people on this call.
Oh,
as well.
Perfect.
Why are we adding 2 minutes if it was added to our backlog after 2 minutes? Like the lead time.
No, we're taking out 2 minutes, aren't we?
We're taking out 2 minutes, and I'm calculating how long it would have taken the red one to finish because I know the throughput is 3.5 or 4 in the second. So I exactly would know if you would have continued working like this in the packaging column. It would have arrived at that time. It's just a mathematical calculation.
Okay,
it makes sense? All right, so let's move to the push to the pull system with work in process limits. And I will quickly just demonstrate what we will do now. I will copy paste the post it's there. Hopefully it works. Oh, come on. Yes, it works. So some of you could probably already imagine what's going to happen. You look at my screen sharing. So again, you put in your names in the purple post-its, please. The same names than before.
Same roles.
Same people, same role, please. Because you already know how to do the chop. Okay. Alexander, perfect. Done.
Watch out, if you want to put it on top, you need to move them all to front. So some of you might lost the keys.
Ah, okay.
Oliver, can you just select them and move them all to front?
Yeah, I will. Ah, already worked, guess. Why is it not working? Oh yeah. Bring the front.
Tuck. I accidentally.
That's perfect.
I got to flow B, but I'm in flow A, so flow B timekeeper should change my sticky note to their name.
So let me look. Bogdan, Andreas, Bojan, Mario,
Anna. Don't worry. I already done that.
Oh, you've okay. done it. Perfect. Thank you. So what will happen now is sales, Vladimir, for example, in flow A will pull the first item inside. He will do his job and move it to done. Then Barbara is allowed to pull it. He will not push it into her overall column. She will pull it to her doing, and only if it left your column, Vladimir, then you are allowed to pull the next one into your doing. Okay. Barbara also, she will move hers into her done column, like teams do, like from backlog to in progress, testing done, blah blah blah. Only if this then leaves the system here, because Vladan is pulling from your done column, then you are allowed, Barbara, to pull from Vladimir. And only then Vladimir is again allowed to pull into his doing, and so on. So there is in the whole system, if we're somewhere here, for example, blah, blah, it would always be only one item in the overall columns. Any questions?
Just to be sure, so only one item in every column.
Yes, exactly. So you forget about the dotted line. This is just your board, like your Scrum or Kanban board with doing and done. But you as a department or team, you are only allowed to work on one item at the time. And you're not allowed to pull in more work if you are not done, if the next column didn't pull your item, right? Only then you are allowed to pull inside work here. Clear?
Yeah.
If you have questions, raise them now. But we're going to do a practice round again, and I will check. So you can practice. Vladimir and Bogdan, sales, please start. Luca, stop. Are you having troubles? Luca?
You're muted.
Oh, it didn't unmute it? Oh, wait, I thought the space button should have muted it. Never mind. Yeah,
because
no problems.
Because there were actually two items in your doing.
Entirely my bad. Entirely my bad.
Okay, so continue. Just continue. And packaging, of course, is allowed to push it into the send, but you already did that. Perfect. Mm-hmm. Okay. Packaging. Are you having trouble?
Guys.
Who pushed into Vladan?
Vladan pushed into one. So, yeah.
And Vladan, you're not allowed to have two items in your whole box.
Absolutely. Sorry. Yes. But for one moment, I've forgotten.
Enthusiastic. That's fine.
I was just like fast too much.
Okay. So as I can see, nobody pushes anything. It's always pulling from the done. You're not allowed to push into the doing of the next column. Everyone pulls work. There were two again in sizing. Maybe it's just a graphical interference here. I don't know. But that looks good. I think you can stop and delete the already done stuff. You can just delete everything. And I will just copy paste a few more post-its here. That we are not out of work after some time. And then in a few seconds, I will again count down from 5 and we're doing the whole thing as we already did in the push system. So prepare your stopwatch, please. And tell me when you're ready for work, the timekeepers.
I'm ready, but
okay.
Is Alexander going to delete these boxes in Flowway?
That would be. I will do it. Someone did. Thank you. Boris.
Okay, great.
Ready?
Ready.
Perfect. Then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start. And after 2 minutes, I will again tell you to stop working and we will count stuff and like that. So faster. I want money. dollars like this. Packaging. You're doing a great job, actually, but could you do faster, please? I still find it interesting how the velocity changed in the first round from 7 items to 2 or 2 to 3. Interesting. Funny.
Usual business stuff.
I haven't seen this yet. Okay. 40 more seconds. Go. Packaging. That looks great. Mm-hmm. Oh. You missed one, right? Yeah, that's okay. So 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop working, please. Okay, let's see what's the work in progress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in flow number A. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4 in flow number. Oops, what happened? Bring to front. Four in flow number B. Okay. So, no. Bring the front. Yes, thank you. I will not count the throughput now because I think it's fine. We have 3 here and we have 5 there. You actually got better. That's unfair. Never mind. I will now introduce a very important work item again. You are not allowed to pre-product. Stop it. I saw it. And here again. And everyone ready? We will continue in a few seconds. Timekeepers ready?
Yes.
Yes. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and continue working, please. Packaging. You get a nice Christmas present if you go to work faster. As soon as you have, if in your workstation you're done with the red item, then you can stop working again. Like Vladimir, Bogdan, Andreas, Bojan, Mario, you can stop working. Oh, yeah, you can stop working. That's fine. So the red item is finished after 3, 5, I guess, right? In flow B. Oh, 3, 5, -2. Almost there. And here we are at 135. So 35. So actually, we are done here. So what you can see now is here, this round in a pull system, we have a lead time of 135 for the red item. And in flow B, we actually have 1 minute and 5 seconds. So I will open the debrief session and you can find it on outline number 5. And I would like to invite you to just note down what you experienced, what was the difference when working in A, in round A, 1 or round 2? What was the difference in round 2? Okay. Interesting. And what else? Interesting. Probably those are too much post-its here. I'm going to read out some of them. focus, less stress, more communication. In pre-production, I wasn't creating work. Pre-production was much more relaxed. Push was intense and stressful. Less work to do, less it felt this way. I love pull. Easy money, focus. Do one task at a time, focus. Our boss was happier. Oh, yeah. You realized that one. Great. Should I still share my screen or do you want to watch on the mural now?
Well, I would say for the sake of recording, it makes
sense. Yeah, you're totally right. Thank you for reminding me. I forgot that one. Okay, perfect. So let's do a few thought experiments for now. As you can see, the throughput was almost the same. And as you worked on the columns, you already mentioned this in your postings, you had less stress, you had more focus, and less work in round number two. What could you have done with this time?
Help other teammates.
What else?
Write documentation.
Okay, what else?
Improve ourselves.
Yeah.
To do even better.
Yeah. What else?
Do you have a coffee?
Yes.
Bikes.
Yeah.
To train other colleagues.
Wow. Yes. Time for improvement. What else? I mean, you saw the bottleneck, right?
Yeah. Resolve the bottleneck.
Yes.
Jump in.
Exactly. Help. Yeah, exactly. As you saw, and I will move here quick to number six. We had a lead time here of how much was it? I think 7 minutes. I noted it down somewhere. It was 7 minutes. Yeah. And here we had a lead time of
135.
So the red item was how many times quicker in the pool?
Almost five times.
Yeah. And let's imagine we put it in after 2 minutes. What would have happened if we had pushed it in after 10 minutes, the red one?
50 times.
Yeah, exactly. The system would have gone over and over and over and more and more stuff inside, and you will become slower and slower and slower. So let's imagine there is a customer, I approach you, your company, and I ask you in the pull system, in the push system, I need this immediately. When will it be done? What can you answer me?
Eventually.
It'll be done when it gets done and stop asking questions. We don't like our customers very much.
Can you give me any time frame? A serious one, please.
Yes, no. Between now and the next year, it will most certainly probably be done at around 50% chance.
Okay. So...
You practice that one.
Yeah, in a push system, it's an unstable system. You simply can't tell. Another question is: are you doing delivery estimations in your companies or something like this?
Yes.
Are you doing estimations?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what we just found out is you could also roll dice instead. Maybe that's more fun than estimating. Because you simply don't know. Yeah, you're lying to each other all the time. And I'm still not sure why are we still playing these games in unstable systems. It makes no sense, honestly. So no priorities, no customer satisfaction. Someone said it in the second round, I was more satisfied. In pull systems, we have stable and therefore predictable production times. I mean, in reality, it can still vary a little. But if we, at a certain point, started measuring how much work we can do, we can probably be much more predictable and honest. And we can tell people, yeah, look, we have four items in our system and we know how much work we can do because we're measuring stuff lead time. And we can tell you, maybe this will be somewhere around, I don't know, February 22, we can deliver it. And that's a probably more serious. So estimations could make sense here as well. Yes. And it's predictable to the customer, at least much more predictable than in the others. I will jump over Little's Law. There is a mathematical, if you're interested, you can look it up. Little's Law is the mathematical formula that proves actually the throughput by dividing work in process by throughput. The lead time, sorry, exactly. So if we divided the work in process up here, I think it was 27, yeah. By the throughput, we would probably somewhere be the same, like 7. You can see 27 divided by 3.5 is almost the same number. This is the mathematical proof here. Okay. So, if we take a look back here in this system in flow A, let's assume. And I've seen this in companies for several times already, and I will just move some post-its here to simulate that the system is still loaded. What sometimes happens then when a red item here comes in is with a high prio because the hippo, the chef or whoever says, I need this item done because this is a very important customer. So I give this a high priority and I will call it triple A. And please finish this before you do any other thing. So you throw it in here and you leave the green ones untouched because you have to work on this, okay? When will it be done if you ignore all the other stuff?
Well, the lead time is the same as...
Exactly, the lead time is the same, yes. What will happen to all the green post-its meanwhile?
Lead time is getting increased.
It will get increased, okay. And this works for one time, but normally you have more customers and you have more important customers. And so you probably, I've seen this also, you have more than one priority triple A ticket. You have another one and maybe another one. I'm not sure. I was just copy pasted how it is in your companies. And what will happen now?
We have no idea.
Everything is standing still until all the reds are packaged.
Exactly. And probably you will have the same troubles with the reds if you continue to prioritize them like this. Like you did with the greens before, you will exactly run into
eventually,
the same problems.
Everything will become red.
Exactly. So what people or companies then often do is they invent a new priority. They call it triple A plus. Okay?
I have a flashback here.
And then we do the same game with triple A plus and so on and so on and so on. And we're back in the old systems. And then there comes the best idea. Now all the green ones, we just make them red and yeah, okay.
Or even make them not important, like at all. Like
so
low priority.
Yes, you have exactly. So if everything has priority, nothing has priority in the end. And I've seen this quite a few times and it's always leading down the same road, nowhere. Okay, let's assume that Barbara here in column 2, this is team Barbara, yeah, sure? And this is development. And let's imagine someone has the idea, let's make Barbara agile. Okay, we introduce Scrum here because you know, twice to work in half the time and stuff like that. You've heard that? Okay. We make,
I really like where this is going.
We scrumify Barbara. And she will work very fast now. What would have happened?
Absolutely nothing.
Why?
There will be a different bottleneck. So the next step would become a bottleneck then.
Exactly. So what does local optimization do to a whole system?
Nothing.
If it's not at the bottleneck, it does nothing.
Mm-hmm. So someone said if they are quicker here, certainly, then they will make produce a bottleneck here. Someone said that, right?
Yep.
Okay, so on what does that mean for the whole system if they are quicker and make a new bottleneck here?
Sorry.
They will hate me.
Yes, they will hate you, exactly. Exactly, nothing happens. You're not getting faster. You're still stuffing, you're making, producing bottlenecks here and nothing changes. Welcome to systems thinking. Mm-hmm. And as you can imagine, a lot of companies try that. They try to optimize local parts of their value streams. And then often they wonder, why are things not changing? We introduced agile methodologies in our IT, didn't we? Yes, you did. It didn't count the other parts on the value stream because we're talking about end-to-end delivery. It didn't take those into account and it didn't help you to put a Ferrari motor into a Beetle chassis. Oh, okay. All right. funny thing here. Mm-hmm. So in the second round, what we also introduced, this is called, and maybe some of you probably know that, some kind of points of commitments. So that means I only commit myself to work that I can actually really do. So you pulled the work. And if I ask you, is that the case in your companies? Are you allowed to do that? And how do you feel about how is it working at your workplaces? I will stop sharing now. Anyone the same experiences or?
You mean as the pull or I forgot the name.
Pull and push and work in progress limits, yes.
Yeah, of course. I mean, everybody works in some system, right? So either one or the other.
I mean, I have a feeling that at least for our development teams, we're using pull system where we have a product owner, dedicated product owner in the team who, of course, it's his job or hers, whatever, to try and push things.
Mm-hmm.
But it's developers are in charge of saying, this is what we want to pull from your product backlog to our Scrum backlog,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So, but still, that's only in one part of the system, right?
Mm-hmm.
We have a great barber.
Yeah, we have a great barber.
Applause, Barbara.
Sorry, Barbara.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but typically I don't see that on all levels. There's always, especially on managerial level or at the top level, you will always get to quarterly planning.
Mm-hmm.
And while there is some value in it, in a business sense.
Yeah.
You cannot provide it by giving estimations in the old-fashioned way.
Mm. Mm. Okay.
I can think of a worse thing. You don't have a plan at all, none whatsoever, no planning whatsoever.
As long as there are no commitments, that's not a bad thing.
No, there are commitments, just no planning.
You need a customer who will understand that.
I can share with you one more very funny or interesting graphics that was developed by Klaus, and he always shows it in his presentations. It looks like this. I find it very funny. Oh. So, the end-to-end delivery from the first idea to the done state over the whole company. Actually, you have to take in account everything, the whole system. Otherwise, it does not make sense to introduce agility anywhere. And I know this
is where to start.
This is hard to take at the start. Yeah. And that's why when we work with flight levels, and that's why we're here today, I guess. We try to make sure that the whole company understands actually what we want to do. And that's why we play with them those games too. And we also do some introduction workshops and stuff like this to make sure that they really, really understand where they lose the money and where they lose customers and stuff like this, if they don't take the whole picture into account and start working with the whole system and not start somewhere with local optimization, because this mostly needs some, most of the times at least, to frustrations and blaming, and I actually had such customers, then they blamed ID why you need working faster, and they blamed back, well, you are not prioritizing, and whatever you can imagine. Any conflicts came up in this point of time, and when they first thought about, well, let's work together on solving this problem from alpha to omega, then it could work. And I will actually show you how such a workshop looks like in real. If I can find it. Yeah, here it is. Exactly. That's a flow, a flight level system architecture workshop. You can see.
Sorry,
here.
Oliver. We still see end-to-end flow problem.
Sorry, I will share again. Intelligent system it is. You can see it now?
Yeah.
Okay. This is how a flight level architecture workshop looks like. So here we have some introduction phase. You often do this upfront a day before and also do this flow experiment game. Then we go into the steps here. We want to find out what products and services actually are you working on in your company. What are the dependencies between your value offerings and which teams or persons work on which of these three flight levels that we have in the flight level system, which actually is flight level one, the team boards. They are connected to an end-to-end coordination board. And this is connected to a strategy board. There are different versions. It's different every time. There is no blueprint. And that's why I already told you in the introduction, that's what I really like about this, because it's only a thinking model. This is not a method or a framework or anything. You have to think about what are actually our products? How does our system work? What's our customers? And how does the flow through the systems look like if we want to optimize value streams? And you have to develop everything on your own. What we do is in the first scenario is we create a flight levels architecture. So we want to find out what's actually the topology of your company. And I will show you some topology here. This is actually AutoScout 24. And what we did in these workshops is we identified what products you have, and you can see them here. Those are the gray things. And they had products like a core experience, and they had a dealer platform. So that's not a dealer, it's a platform, it's a web platform. It's the product is called dealer. And they have a private seller platform, and then they found out these and these and these teams are working there. And then we have also departments like HR, sales, marketing, lawyers, blah, blah, blah. And how are those things connected together, or how should they be connected? If we found out those are flight level two systems which need to coordinate work, the coordination of the teams. So we coordinate teamwork on flight level two, end to end. And here the special cases, they also introduced a flight level 2.5 port to coordinate the flight level 2 boards. It's called the operational portfolio board. This is interesting for the stakeholders. They don't want to go into the different boards or into the different teams to see how the how work is proceeding and when will stuff be done or whatever metrics they use, like OKRs or KPIs, I don't know. It doesn't actually matter. And it also doesn't matter if you're using Scrum or Kanban or whatever. It doesn't matter. This is all about coordinating work and find out bottlenecks. Visualize it on the boards. Okay, in real, this looks like this. This is the first draft of how their work is coordinated now, how the products and teams that are working on. And as you can see, this is totally messy because it's simply uncoordinated. There are no coordination ports at the moment. And this here, this was actually 2 days ago. This is a communication graph. So all these stakeholders and teams you can see in the outer circle, these are their communication flows. And this is, wow. I mean, it's nearly impossible to handle such complexity in communication if you don't give it a thought how to do it. If a company just grows and you don't take care how this should work. So what we then do in the next step is we actually identify what kind of work do you have in your systems. And like business as usual, we also call it white noise. Like, I don't know, application management and sprint plannings and testing and code reviews and whatever you can imagine is business as usual, which is not part of a board actually, but you have to do the work. So it takes time. Then we have the simple column here. These are something like small GUI changes or things that can be done by one team, like on maintenance work or new story, small one, or simple change requests. And then we have the complex items. These are called flight items, by the way, and I will show you later what flight items means. These are complex and big things that have a big scope, or it needs more than one team to be involved in the value delivery. And these are called flight items. What are flight items? This is an example of how they are named. It doesn't matter how you actually name those things in your company. And it's all really the whole thinking model of flight levels is agnostic. It doesn't force you to use anything that's already, pre-prescribed. You can think of anything yourself, which actually lowers the resistance when you change, when you have a change initiative or something. So let people come up with their own ideas, with their own namings. Let them own this stuff. Don't tell them, don't pre-prescribe, because it leads to resistance mostly. Strategy items, mostly on a company wall on flight level 3, as you remember, where we should prioritize the work that will then be pulled into the system of level 2 is around 1 to 3 years. So long-term strategic goals. A canvas doesn't have a size actually, but like a business model canvas or stuff, maybe you need to verify or evaluate the business value of a strategy idea. So this could be a flight item because it mostly needs to be evaluated on flight level 2 with the product owners there that help the business to evaluate what's the actual business value. And then it goes up back to the flight level 3 where it is approved or not. I will show you the boards later. Initiatives actually take between 1 or 3 months. So container for flight level 2 probably. Epics, flight level 2, and will be broken down into flight level 1, into stories and stuff like that. Those are flight items. Then we have so-called flight routes what we also find out when we defined the flight items, like you saw. If I'm too quick with scrolling, please tell me. I know I'm sometimes a bit quick. We defined the flight items here. Then we want to find out what and I showed you this, what kind of flight items are actually should take place on which flight level. So here you can see we defined it. People found out, okay, this is big enough to be on flight level 2 because it needs to be coordinated here. A new functionality needs to be coordinated because several systems could be affected. So we have to take care of this here and talk to several product owners in whatever meetings you have there. Same. We don't pre-prescribe reviews or retrospective or whatever. We just call it inspect and adapt events, and however you want to name them, we don't care. It's totally up to you. And then we try to find out, and how do these items actually float over our boards in the future? So this is here, and this is an example. For example, someone has an idea on the company strategy or whatever. It will then be evaluated on flight level 2, as already mentioned, as a canvas. And then it will be transformed back into an initiative item and come to level 3, where it's then approved or rejected. If it's approved, it will come back to flight level 2 as an initiative, will be broken down into epics, smaller pieces of work, you probably know that, and then will be copied into flight level 1 again and broken up into stories. So you can see the whole value chain is here visualized on a board or on several boards, and it's always taken in account that we're not agile on a team level here, but the whole thing is working in an agile manner. So we have the whole inspect and adapt idea here. It looks like this again. I'll show you this. So it's absolutely necessary to inspect and adapt on every level. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense. Because if we take 1 year here to find out we did the wrong thing, that's quite expensive. So prioritization must start here. We always prioritize on flight level number 3. Because otherwise, people will start work here. And the question now for you is, and I show you this huge board. That's an example board. There you can see this point of commitment. What if we didn't prioritize here and just stuffed work inside our flight level 2 system? And after, let's say, 6 months, we found out that we need to work on something else and stop this because we don't look into it regularly. What would that mean to the existing work?
It's being paused.
And it's decaying, which is even worse.
Yeah.
And it's going to cost if you ever want to get back to it.
Yes.
Is it similar like we invented the red sticky note?
Yeah. So actually what you do here is you don't, if that's the case, what I just told you, you don't finish work. And that's the worst thing you could do. Because you already used, I don't know, probably millions of euros in 6 months. I don't know how many teams you have in your companies. But if I can imagine 20 teams working on something for 6 months, we're talking about figures. Thank you. And you didn't finish that. So this is sunk cost. Maybe something changed during this year. Maybe a competitor came up with an idea that you're behind, and then you start developing this new idea. That's sunk cost, because this is worthless what you did. And that's why we have in a pull system this point of commitment where you pull, like similar to our flow experience, but this here is a real board. You only commit here, and if you have, let's say, 8 items here, this is less much money that you invested and actually delivered value than if you have the whole system full with undone work. It doesn't deliver value because it's not finished. And if you have to change it because something in the market popped up, and we're talking about business agility here, then you are too slow or you have to throw it away. And that makes no sense at all. And that's why Klaus always says agility is not team sport. It's company sport. And it's really important that executives realize that they're shooting into their, how is there an English phrase for ins Knie schießen?
Kneecapping themselves, basically.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So this is an example board. This is another example board here. What they are actually doing, they have increment plannings here, PI plannings, and there are always different kind of boards. So there is no blueprint. For example, if you take a look here at the first board, that are swim lanes. So they have products or services in swim lanes. And this is one huge board where they can see dependencies early because all the things are connected together. And if I were a customer or I don't know, some kind of stakeholder, I could have a look at this board. And with one view, I could exactly see where we are and we could talk about things that are on the board. And I could also show, okay, if you, dear customer, if you want to have this thing here, you see we have those tickets or these items in flight. We can do it probably in, your game in February 22 or whenever, because we know what's our lead times and throughput. Okay. I will show you quickly how we get there when we define the flight routes. This is an example. Also from, no, it's actually from yesterday, yeah. So they have these flight routes like an initiative here, or a strategic, and then they find out what has to happen here. Where does it go? Does it need to go down here to be broken down or not? And you see, they develop everything on their own. There is no prescription because nobody actually knows how it should like in your company. So if someone tells you, let's do save and we exactly know everything, it's always the same. No, it's not. It's simply not. That's a lie. And then they iterate it over time. So the whole board thing and the flow needs to be iterated over time with inspect and adapt as well. So retrospectives or reviews on the board itself. If a board looks the same in this, after 1 year, you probably didn't iterate it and it shouldn't be that way. So it's all about being agile on the processes and on your communication and whatever. After we have developed the flight routes, then you remember the big depending of the products, then we find out with all the data we have, what are our flight level 2 boards? And after we have identified the flight level 2 boards, in the next workshops, we will, and we have not done this here, so I cannot show it to you yet, but we're going to work on the actual board designs. And you can imagine this looks like this. We will identify value streams. So when, and we will start here at the customer. So we will detect the way back when it's finished and we detect what stations did this go through, was heißt Detektiv? Like Sherlock Holmes, yeah? We find out our way back in the line. So it's already done and then we find out how did this start. And then there is a rough board and then you develop the real thing in this workshop. So you find out what stages are actually is our product in our board, flight level 2 board going through, again, working process limits and stuff, probably you can identify bottlenecks, you will find out things, you will iterate the columns, you will maybe redesign it and so on and so on. Okay. And here we have some patterns, how boards could look like, or which patterns you could take into consideration. Like how do you handle backflow items? If they are reviewed and there is a problem, how do you deal with it? Do you throw it back? What if you have a working process limit of 1 year? So that's not allowed. Actually, then you have 2 years. So what could you do? Instead of a backflow, maybe you introduce fix and review column so that you still provide the working process and not get confused. Or you could do blockers instead of a next column. You just block it, and until it's not fixed, this is blocked here. No more things can be pulled. Okay. Then we have a swim lane system, for example. On the flight level 2 board, how to coordinate like feature 1 or features or changes or production. And they all look a bit different. And there you have working process limits in the swim lanes instead of the columns. This can also be done. So there are several possibilities to handle such things. And this is also interesting as a product swim lanes. Like we have several products in our company, and it was the actual example I showed you, the real one. They did it like that. They have products and services here on swim lanes with different kind of columns and the whole overview of the dependencies. And then you can also think about when you are, and excuse me the word, I'm not very happy to use it, but I don't want to call them resources. How you can staff people if you need some help somewhere. You see it. You see who has time, who has not much work to do and can help out other teams and stuff like this, because you have the whole overview. There's another interesting pattern. It's the blockers pattern. You can collect types of blockers. So you find out over time, these type of work always blocks us. And then you collect them, and then you see, okay, now we have 20 blockers already of this kind of type of work. This seems like a bottleneck. What can we do about it? Inspect and adapt, find out. So visualization, identify bottlenecks, and change and inspect and adapt over the boards. I just moved those. Why did I do that? Interesting. another thing here is we identify these kind of work items, as already shown, the flight items, because everybody in the whole system needs to talk about the same things if we talk about an epic. I've seen it that in some companies, if people talk about a project or a function, they mean totally different things and they are expecting different things. And when I then say the function takes 5 weeks and they say, why 5 weeks? This is a very small thing. It's just 2 days. A function cannot take longer. It's just a button. Oh, okay. Blah, blah, blah. So we identify the items and then we define them together. So we find out how do you call it? That's the arrival. How does it come in into our system, into flight level 2? Describe the type. Where does it come from? Which people are involved there? How does it arrive? So the input channel. What size is it? Is it t-shirt sizes, hours, days, story points? We don't care. And how often does it come into our system, or the rate or intervals and stuff like this? And most important, why is this type of work done? What's the value for the customer? I think that's a central question in a whole value chain. It's always about delivering value in the end. And there you can state it, so that everybody knows, we are doing this because it delivers this and this kind of value. And that actually gives people also a kind of meaning. Why am I coming to work? Why do I spend my time here? okay, of this. This makes sense. Our customer's happy because I'm doing this work every day. And I think it's very important to make this transparent at all time. Give people a sense. That's my personal meaning, if you allow me. Okay. This actually takes around 4 to 5 days only for a first prototype of flight level 2 boards. So if you get a rough estimation, and you can do it between 6-7 people up to 20. We did a workshop with 25, and I have to say this was already a bit more than the limit, and it was really hard time. And if you want to ever try this out, I could give you some tips also. In such kind of workshop, if you work with people from several hierarchies, because you need all of them here in the board workshop to get all the information and data you need, there will pop up all the conflicts that people have in this company. Because actually now they are talking about things where some think this is not none of your business, why you cannot decide it, decide this and stuff like this. So I highly recommend that you make this clear to everyone before you do the workshop. And you also have a strategy how to get out of such a situation if the conflicts arise. And it almost every time happens in some kind of way, sometimes harder, sometimes less hard. I would also recommend not to do this alone. So don't facilitate such a huge thing on your own. At least two people, I would recommend. Also, for remote reasons, it's probably easier if there is someone taking care of the technical stuff and knows exactly what to do, and the other one is maybe more focusing on the attendees, on the people working in the workshop, or focuses on the outcome of the workshop. Okay, so now I told you quite a lot. I can see a few chat. Oh, let's just do a Q&A if you like. I don't know whatever are your wishes. How could I help you, or is this already enough for you? I mean, we have done almost 2 hours now.
Oliver, we have one question.
Sure.
It's from Bojan, but he left.
Oh, so sorry.
Yes, have you done this? I didn't want to interrupt you. Have you done this with more people in column, this exercise that you're doing?
Which exercise that we did?
Yes.
The penny game,
experiment?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, sure. I've done it a few times already. Also with my customers.
The question was with more than one person doing the job within the one column, I guess.
Oh no, it was always one person in one column. Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly. I think it would get too complicated, or I don't know, confusing. But you could try it out and tell me how it works. I'm happy to get the information.
When you're starting with the company, you know, with flight levels for the first time, where do you start?
I start actually with this flow experiment, because then I don't have to explain anything anymore, mostly.
Okay, but then, like, do you first untangle things around flight 1, 2? How does this part work once you finish the workshop? I mean,
Thank you for the question. We mostly, and also Klaus recommends this, you start with a flight level 2 board. It actually makes totally sense to first find out the coordination, and then you connect them to a 3 or the 1 boards. It's much easier then, because you already know the connection points.
I have a question. In your usual workshops, which management level people are gathered there? Is that like board, or is that like middle level management, or? Thank you.
From my experience, it's at least that the guys that contact me, it's mostly middle management. They cry for help. Then we do this game, and almost any time there is some C-level manager included, because he's interested for some reason, I don't know. Or someone from business is taking part in the workshop. And when they see this, they tell their friends. And 2 days later, I get the offer, can you do this for us too, please? Just happened a few days ago. It works. Yeah, without explaining a lot, because you found out yourself what's important in the flow experiment. I didn't tell you much. Does that answer your question, Mario?
Yeah, thanks.
Perfect.
I think it even makes more sense if you're doing this with with middle management, that C-level people are there. That, at least from my perspective, because it gives them no matter how much you explain this to the middle management, if the guys above are not aboard, you're doing it for nothing.
Exactly. it doesn't help because they still will stuff your system. They will push work on you.
Yeah.
What we tried with our latest customer is that we announced a head product owner who is the master of the level two. And he's a very strong and influential person. And he can actually, he actually has the power to say, our system is full and I can help you to find out when your work is done. But you have to realize that if you don't have this power, you could lose your job. Simple as that. Because if the boss says, I want this done, you're done. So yes, it totally makes sense to have everyone on board and make your company bosses or whoever is responsible in the end aware of this. And if you get him to play this game, try it, because then he will understand that he loses probably hundreds, thousands and millions of euros every year. And that's their language.
Yeah. And just to go back to one of the previous questions, like question was where to start, like and if we have all of these departments like product, engineering, sales, customer support, customer success, and we're identifying that the problem is with in one or maybe two departments that are working together, let's say product and engineering, right? Because they're in charge of delivering the value to the customer. Does it make sense to do it isolated within those two departments? Not to include much more people, like maybe it will work better if it's only within those two departments.
I spill the question back to the audience. What do you think?
I think we answered that in this exercise.
Can you say it again, maybe?
Yeah, if we optimize the team Barbara, we will just create a bottleneck in the next step, right? So if product and engineering are team Barbara, then whatever next step is will become the bottleneck. It could be customer services, it could be sales, it
operations, could be- whatever.
Yeah.
And then they are the bad guys and the blaming will start again.
Yeah, but our conscience is clear.
Yeah, we're good. We're good.
Somebody else's problem.
Yeah. Exactly. Uh-huh. Thanks for answering it, Anna.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, anyone else? Can I help you?
Oliver, I'll put your contact in the chat that people can reach you.
That's what I wanted to.
Oh, yeah, sure. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me anytime. I'm happy to help out.
And recording of this meeting, is that going to be available to us maybe?
Tomorrow.
On the website, I guess.
When you wait
YouTube
to-
channel.
On our YouTube channel.
Oh, awesome. Awesome.
Boris is burning midnight oil, as always.
Boris, before you release the video, can we have a quick chat, or we stay in the meetup for a few more minutes?
Yes,
that would be great. Thank you.
You and me and Bogdan.
Cool.
Great. Thank you, Oliver, for sharing the knowledge to fly safety with you. Thank you once more for everything.
Awesome. You can contact me anytime. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, this was great.
Thank you.
Enjoy your evening. Bye.
See you in 2 weeks, guys.
Bye, guys.
Hopefully I did not hurt any Scrum fans that now think, what have I done during the last years?
Yeah, I don't think so. This doesn't conflict with Scrum, by the way. I don't see it that way. So
you no, it does not. Scrum, it does not.
Yeah, you could use Scrum. You don't have to. That's the whole point.
As long as you're aware that just using Scrum in one team is probably not going to help solve any big issues.
Exactly. It will not help the value chain creation, though.
And it was great meetup, guys. Cheers.
Yep.
Bye. But bye. It's thank fun you. Anyway, maybe.
Bye.
Bye.
Some colored retros or.
Thank you, Oliver. Bye. See you.
Thank you, Maya.
Bye.
Thank you from the packaging side. Bye bye, guys.
Yeah, thank you, Alexander. Well done.